Hey everybody, I'm David Rosengarten, filling in for Sarah Moulton. I'm here with Rose Levy Beranbaum, author of The Cake Bible, and we are making some really great Easter desserts. We are mid-cheesecake, so without any further ado, yes. Show, now, how do you make the filling?
We have cream cheese, just regular Philadelphia cream cheese, and sugar that has been beaten together.
As a matter of fact, we have 2 8-ounce packages of Philadelphia cream cheese.
A pound.
Softened, 1 pound. And there's sugar in there right now as
yes,
well?
Yes, it's much been sugar? Beaten together.
One cup sugar.
I thought so.
Beaten together with the paddle. For how long did you beat that?
Oh, maybe 3 minutes.
Okay.
You can't really overbeat when you use the paddle.
Is that right? So if a phone call came and
yeah,
I went...
Yeah, that's one time you don't have to worry. Although it's not a good policy to take phone calls while you're in the middle of baking.
Okay.
Okay.
3 eggs go in there as well.
Just
whole
get
eggs,
it started.
Not just yolks, 3 eggs.
Exactly.
Rose,
in
would
this
you
instance,
say that this is a... There's a lot of cheesecakes in the world, but this looks to me like it's got sort of New York roots. Yes, this is a New York
definitely
kind of cheesecake?
Definitely so. It's the creamy style. It doesn't have any ricotta cheese or usurpers like that, false prophets.
You know? Oh, that's probably not what they
sorry,
think in Italy,
sorry,
but
sorry.
Okay. You were born in
I'm
New York,
Yorker.
I take that. Okay.
You are too, right?
I am a New
so
Yorker.
You should understand.
A couple of New Yorkers making cheesecake
actually,
for Easter.
this is the kind of cheesecake that people like when they think they don't like cheesecake. You know, it's
yeah.
like a creamy custard
yeah.
and lemony. But the real secret...
Do people think they don't like cheesecake?
Believe it or not, yeah.
Really?
Because they're thinking
they're
of those
wrong.
Dense, dry, you know, full of flour, whereas this is like ice cream only, not frozen.
Before and you go ahead, let's cover all the things you just put in there. There was a
sure.
quarter teaspoon of salt.
Mm-hmm.
So some other little powdery things.
There was a
little bit
of cornstarch, which is what I said you can leave out if you use all yolks.
Right, right. And
but otherwise, you'll get a little watering out if you don't.
Okay.
And then, because we have so much of the sour cream, and that's what gives it that lilting, addictive.
That's
I mean,
why we're using it,
breakfast.
Because we have so much of it? No.
No.
You're going to put it, okay.
Did I say that?
Because we have so much sour cream, let's put it in.
Because we have so much sour cream, we have to use a little bit of cornstarch or to use all yolks so that it thickens it. Because sour cream may look thick now, but actually it's just as thin as if you use heavy cream when you bake.
Interesting.
Okay.
Because it sort of melts, it liquefies
exactly.
while it's baking.
Exactly. It just looks like it's thicker, but
right.
actually it has the same moisture content.
She knows so much. I'm in awe. This is what I look like when I'm in awe. Okay, go ahead. So that's 3 cups of sour cream.
Yeah. And then we just mix it in until it's uniform in color.
Mm-hmm.
Shall we assume that it's
you mean no
there
yellow
and
white streaks?
Yeah, and no lumps.
Can you ratchet it up? Can you bring up the speed? Yes, you can.
I'm
you
not
will.
Emerald, but I can ratchet it up a notch.
Okay.
So I love that
now
term.
It's one color, no streaks.
Right, and now it's just going to simply get poured on top of these ladyfingers.
Let's see.
And David,
let's
I'm going to need that spatula back because okay. you really want every last bit of this wonderful stuff and
do.
It's all going to fit in.
Let's see your pouring okay. technique.
And you can fill in all those gaps, by the way, should you want to, but it doesn't matter. At
and
the
what,
bottom I'm talking about, because on the
right.
side you have to have it complete, otherwise you won't have a beautiful complete crown effect.
Right.
And then, of course, you can just leave it like this after it bakes, but the crown lends itself to fresh berries, like raspberries or strawberries or
just,
blueberries.
Just like in the window of all those Jewish delis and pastry shops when we were growing up here in New York.
That's right. And yep. as a kid, I would never have eaten cheesecake.
Really?
I never had one
oh,
like this.
So you know wherever you
convert.
Speak, you were one of those cheesecake haters. But you saw the light.
So. Now, here's the trick. To not get your pans all tarnished
yep.
when you use them as a water bath, put a pinch of cream of tartar in.
Mm.
Then pour the water.
Mm, so right in this bottom pan.
Exactly.
Because
okay. you want hot water, hot from the tap, about halfway up the side, and that's what's going to keep it beautifully creamy. Another secret.
And once again, that cream of tartar prevents this bottom pan from being discolored.
Exactly. Otherwise,
okay.
it gets that really hideous grayish color.
Okay.
We're going to have to cover it partway through the baking. It bakes at 350 like everything else, and it bakes for 45 minutes. But at 35 minutes, cover it so that the tips don't get overly brown.
Oh, I see.
And then
cover it with what?
With aluminum foil.
Okay.
And then, when it 45 minutes is up, turn off the oven, don't open the door, leave it for an hour, and
oh,
it continues cooking gently.
Very nice.
When you take it
I
out of the
I bet it becomes
oven,
tender.
Everything I do is tender, you know. But I guess you're getting the idea.
Yes, indeed.
When you take it out, it's kind of shake a little,
mm-hmm.
kind of shimmy Shiggle. Like Jello.
It's shaking a lot now.
Don't expect it to be firm. It will firm up when it's refrigerated. Overnight.
Excellent. Okay.
This can be made a week ahead.
Oh, really? A week ahead? And you,
mm-hmm.
and you can keep it out. Refrigerated.
Absolutely. Anything
the pound
with cheese.
Cake you could keep out on the counter, but
exactly.
this you want to keep in the refrigerator. And wrapped,
and
of course. Always wrapped.
It.
And don't freeze
it ruins
this cake.
The texture.
Because it'll a lot of wetness will come out, a lot of moisture will come out.
It just gets curdled because of all the moisture.
It'll taste more like that ricotta cheesecake.
I shouldn't have said that in the first place, so don't repeat it.
Come with me, get the water.
And then we'll get back to our glaze for the strawberries.
We are here at 350 degrees, the magic number. Okay.
In the middle of the oven, as usual.
You want to fill that up right here?
Sure.
We're doing this over here, of course, because it's easier to...
Because when you walk with a pan full of hot water, it's not safe.
Yeah.
But now we're right
That's
close.
That's it? So, about halfway.
Halfway.
Okay.
That's it.
Center of the oven.
Now, was this not easy?
350. This is very easy. Now, 350, once again, you said after 35 minutes, we're going to cover it with some foil loosely to protect
it. Or if you see that it's browning sooner, cover it sooner. It won't hurt.
Okay. So after all that.
It protects your tips. See how the tips are lightly browned?
The tips are lovely.
Thank you.
Lovely. Just perfect tips on this cake. All right, now this one is all done. It sat in the, turned off oven for an hour, I think you said?
Yes, and then at room temperature for an hour because you can't put a hot cake into a refrigerator. And then it must sit for at least 6 hours refrigerated, so do it overnight. This is something to do the day before.
You prefer to do this the day before.
Mm.
Yeah.
It's safer. I've done it otherwise.
Now this strawberrying and glazing, does that happen just before? Or do you want to do that the day before also?
No, that you do the same day because, you know, berries don't hold up all that well.
Okay.
But glaze helps to keep it fresher.
What's in here?
This is simply currant preserves that has been heated, strained so that it wouldn't be at all lumpy, and then heated again. And you don't have to add anything else, but I like Chambord, which is black raspberry liqueur.
Go ahead, add it.
Why not?
And if you don't have Chambord, you could use any sweet raspberry liqueur.
Cassis.
Creme de cassis.
Which was that marvelous one you mentioned?
There's a guy in California, Randall Graham, at Bonnie Doon Vineyard. He makes this great raspberry wine that I think would be good in here also.
I like his wines.
Yeah.
You can smell it kind of.
It smells great.
Okay,
all right, let's see. Just start to show us the glaze.
If it were toothpick, it would glop on it. And you don't do this on a sliced strawberry because a glaze on a sliced berry slides right off.
I see. So you want to do it
actually,
they're sliced on the bottom a little bit to get the stems and the hulls out. But
exactly.
But on the.
But don't slice the part that you're glazing. Now, see, this is puddling. Normally, I fill the entire top with it, but I think it looks really pretty like this too. I would boil this down a little bit thicker. See, it's a little bit watery, but it's okay because it will give it a shine and make it glossy.
Oh, look how
glossy.
It sparkles. I love that. Okay,
that's
listen, next
purpose.
We're going to take, we talked about the brownie puddle thing. Well, that's it. We're going to do the brownie puddle, which is something that I'm looking forward to. It's going to be so good. Come back.